Booming out in South Bend like Lou Will, six men like Lou Will, two girls and they get along like on Lou Will. I just got the new deal, I am in the matrix and I just took the blue pill. No whole shit, no fucking whole shit, say that for your shit. I don't need no fucking body, I run my own shit. I told you, thought I told you, you didn't listen. Fieri, I'm in the kitchen, I'm a magician, I'm on it. I'm like MacGyver, I'm Michael Myers. I kill careers and cut the lights off, the shit is frightening. I knew it would end up like this, I'm fucking psychic. Young, but I'm making millions to work the night shift. Yeah, work the night shift. Young, but I'm making millions to work the night shift. Work the night shift. Young, but I'm getting every single motherfucking thing I'm owed. You gotta know, I'm here to fuck with niggas' souls. My heart is cold, it's probably cause I'm from the snow. With all my woes, I know they wanna see me go. I'm on a roll, I mean, I'm back on this again. I'm here again, you know the truth, let's not pretend. I'm not your friend, not your guy, I'm not your buddy. Show no love, and I might go to Marcus Cousins out in public. Man, I'm back on this again, I'm here again. I didn't do this fucking tape for CNN. I am not trying to win awards, that shit look forced. It's nothing like this. Young, but I'm making millions to work the night shift. Yeah, work the night shift. Young, but I'm making millions to work the night shift. Work the night shift.
Squats are complete. I think this is the fastest I've ever done squats. But welcome to today's vlog. So this whole week is a deload. Deloads kind of suck. You're not really doing a lot of weight. But I mean, relative weight. My voice just cracked. That's nice. Caught that on camera. But basically, I'm doing 390. That's what it looked like a good relative weight to kind of deload at for a double. Because last week I did 435. So how I do it is I've already talked about PR's performance, but I like his analogy of deloads, and you know, he had a very interesting way to do it, and I'm giving it a shot, and I like that because my old deloads just used to be kind of like RPE whatever. It would be like RP5 or 6, and like kind of hard to gauge sometimes, especially when you're feeling really good. And I'd rather not screw myself up for this upcoming block, because this upcoming block is my last block. I'm doing single, so I don't want to mess anything up, so just keeping it, you know, the intensity's there at least. I'm feeling good doing it, so yeah. So we got accessories now, so I'm gonna get on to that. So quick tip, if you're programmed Bulgarian split squats, what's it called? To get kind of the perfect setup from distance to, you know, putting your foot. I'm sorry, I'm very winded. I just did a set and I thought I should give a tip of how I do it. So basically, take a seat. So I'm sitting down, point your foot out, strain it out, point it out, whatever you want. As you step forward, that's where you'll set your dumbbells, and then you could put your foot back. It's a perfect distance. It always works. That way you don't have to kind of play around and try and find an angle or whatever. I think this is the first time I've shown my strength day accessories and all. I don't know. I don't remember if I have. But finishing up, shoulder press, did Bulgarian split squats, and finishing up with leg curls. Leg curls were supposed to be after Bulgarian split squats, but I was like, I'm gonna just do abs right now and then call it. So I got leg curls, standing leg curls, and we're gonna finish up and then go home and then eat. And then I'll explain a little bit of what a deload is from my understanding, you know, because we're still learning. So let's finish this up. Again, good indication of strength gains is when your accessories are moving and you're putting on more weight. That was a 25 and a 10. Never done that. Been 25, then 25 and 5, 25 and 2.5. Today's 25 and 10. So, really good for 10. So, shit. Okay, and we're back home. I'm currently waiting for my wrap to kind of cool down a little bit, because we gotta eat that and like one more thing to kind of round out my calories. But anyways, I wanted to end off this video kind of explaining a little bit about what a deload is. Basically, a deload, you just kind of pull back a little bit of your intensity. It's not to detrain you though, it's just to manage your fatigue a little bit better. The reason for it is, for me specifically, when I start to feel a little bit demotivated to train, or like generally that I don't want to, like I love training. So when I start to feel that feeling of I'd rather do other things, or you know, like it becomes easier to skip, that's when I'm like, yeah, I'm probably gonna need a deload. And I felt that on Wednesday when I had deadlifts, and again on Friday, I was editing and I was just like, I'm too tired, I wanna go nap. Well, I ended up sleeping, so it wasn't really a nap, but I ended up sleeping and then just deciding to train on Saturday. And then generally I was just like, just going into it. So I knew that it was time. Generally for me, that is when I know. I typically have it set to when I'm just doing training for such a long period of time. So like typically like 8 to 12 weeks for me is a kind of a good range. Although currently though, I think I've been 8 weeks straight. So yeah, like right before my peaking block, which is just top singles all the way up to RP9, where I have one left in the tank. So that'll be a very, very heavy day. Generally, that's where I like to do a deload, right before that block. So that's the purpose of this week being pretty much a deload. But yeah, hopefully that kind of explains it a little bit. I'll try and make the next video a little bit more detailed. I'll show the program and I'll show kind of what, you know, goes on, or the thought process behind, you know, last block and this block, just to kind of show you guys the program side of it. But I do program for myself and I'm diving into a lot of learning, more so because I do want to coach eventually. And even if it's just kind of local meets or just like, I don't want to say lower level lifters, but newer lifters, basically, I would want to dip my feet into it because I do love programming. I feel like I would like helping other people on learning things that I've, you know, particularly learned doing this for now going on to 3 years or 2 years. I forget when I first started. I started at like November, but it was like 2021 or 2022. Yeah, 2021. Pretty sure. Yeah, 2021. So I'm coming up on 3 years. I lied to you. I'm coming up on 2 years, going on to three next year. That's crazy. Okay. But yeah, so that basically explains it. So I'm going to eat. I'm going to, you know, finish up everything. But yeah, so anyways, take care, guys. Love y'all. Be safe. I'll see you.